बाजार में हूं निवेदिता। दुनिया में भारी मंदी के संकेत मिलने लगे हैं, ऐसे में देश के आर्थिक मामले को देखने वाली देश की सबसे बड़ी संस्था नीति आयोग के उपाध्यक्ष के बयान ने हड़कंप मचा दिया कि देश की आर्थिक हालत ठीक नहीं है और ऐसा 70 सालों में पहली बार हुआ है। ऐसा कहना था कि सरकार हरकत में आई और वित्त मंत्री निर्मला सीतारमण ने एक बड़े आर्थिक पैकेज का ऐलान किया। इसी के साथ सरकार का साथ देते हुए दिग्गज IITN नारायण मूर्ति ने भी सरकार का जबरदस्त समर्थन किया और कहा कि ऐसी अर्थव्यवस्था तो पिछले 300 साल में कभी नहीं आई। जो आज माहौल है ऐसा माहौल पहले कभी नहीं था, जो विश्वास और आशावाद को जन्म देता है। इस माहौल के जरिए गरीबी को खत्म किया जा सकता है। उत्तर प्रदेश के गोरखपुर में एक कार्यक्रम के दौरान नारायण मूर्ति ने ये बातें कही। इन्फोसिस के पूर्व चेयरमैन नारायण मूर्ति ने आगे कहा कि हमारी अर्थव्यवस्था इस साल 6-7% की दर से बढ़ रही है। भारत दुनिया का सॉफ्टवेयर विकास केंद्र बन गया है। वहीं विदेशी मुद्रा भंडार ने $400 बिलियन को पार कर लिया है। इन हालात में निवेशक का एहसास ऐतिहासिक ऊंचाई पर है। इसी के समानांतर हमारे देश में एक और भारत बसता है। उस भारत में भयानक गरीबी, भुखमरी, कुपोषण और भ्रष्टाचार है। करोड़ों भारतीय न लिख सकते हैं और न ही पढ़ सकते हैं। ऐसे लोगों को साफ पानी और जरूरी सुविधाएं नहीं मिल पा रही हैं। इन सभी का अनिश्चित भविष्य है। ऐसे हालात में हमें इन लोगों को साथ लेकर चलना होगा और अगर हम आज कड़ी मेहनत करते हैं तो हम आखिरी लाइन में खड़े गरीब बच्चे की आंखों से आंसू पोंछ सकते हैं। ऐसा ही महात्मा गांधी भी चाहते थे। इसके साथ ही साथ नारायण मूर्ति ने देश में मचे राष्ट्रवाद पर भी अपनी बात रखी और अतिवाद में माहौल पर तंज कसते हुए कहा कि तिरंगा लहराते हुए जोर जोर से जय हो और मेरा भारत महान है कहना आसान है, लेकिन मूल्यों का संरक्षण करना मुश्किल। हमें खुद को पहले भारतीय के रूप में पहचानना होगा और राज्यों, धर्म और जाति से ऊपर उठना होगा। नारायण मूर्ति ने आगे कहा कि बोलने और भय से आजादी देश के स्वर्णिम भविष्य के लिए जरूरी है। इनका संरक्षण करना ही असली देशभक्ति है। नारायण मूर्ति ने गोरखपुर में बोलते हुए सरकार को एक तरफ पुचकारा तो दूसरी तरफ घुमा के मारा भी। अब देखते हैं कि आगे क्या होता है और मंदी क्या गोल खिलाती है।
I just want to give a bit of an opening to this, as I see, much expected press conference. I'll have the finance secretary help me in going through the slides. I just want to give you a picture of how long it's going to be so that you're not going to be frustrated in between. There are about 32 slides. And just so that you get a picture of how we are going about this whole thing, I've arranged them in about 6 compartments. So, as we move, I will alert you to the fact that I've covered one and I'm moving to the second, so that related items are grouped under one head. And even before I start doing that, just to briefly give you a picture of what's globally happening. The slide before you shows that the global situation is very clear. And the current projected global GDP growth is of about 3.2% and probably is going to be even revised downwards. Moreover, not just one, many organizations have come out repeatedly to say the global demand is going to be very weak. So that's one broad picture. The lines there show you very clearly what is the growth globally and where India stands in that. You can see the yellow line which stands for India is still very much high above. The United States and Germany have seen inversion of yield curves, which points to slowdown in growth of consumption in these countries also. So it's not a story just of the emerging economies, but even global advanced economies are facing this. And obviously, being in India, we normally get compared with China. So, as a result of the US and China trade war and subsequent currency devaluation of China, a very volatile situation has developed in the global trade. These are nothing new for you, but I just wanted to place it as a larger context with which we are speaking. And therefore, if you see the 10 major economies of the world, the size of the what you call the balloons or whatever, bulbs, show the size, and from among the emerging economies, the size of the economy, and therefore where they stand globally today. So the size of the circle represents the GDP as per PPP and the current international dollar terms. So you see India again in yellow, positioned comfortably very high. The growth rate still in comparison to many of these countries high, and if anything, even compared to China and the United States, our growth rate is higher than everybody else. So let's just keep that at the back of our mind, even as we go through this. One thing I just want to draw your attention to is the important line which the Prime Minister keeps repeating because he strongly believes in it, which came out in one of the newspaper interviews that he had given earlier, saying, "We respect wealth creators." I want to very clearly put that before here, before you, to underline that that's the spirit with which the budget was presented, and that's the spirit with which we immediately invited different sectors of the economy to come and speak to us if there's anything that they wanted to say. And they were not consultation for the sake of it. They were in-depth consultation, some of which ran for even a couple of hours. And all our secretaries were together with me during those consultation process, which ran through a whole week. And many of you all kept following us closely on that. I was happy for that. And just so that we again put this fact in context, that this government, even from 2014, has kept reform at the top of the agenda. It's an ongoing process for us. It's not as if in this tenure, post-2019, we've forgotten the reform agenda. Not at all. Reform is a continuous process, and we are treating it as a continuing endeavor. And therefore, just so that we don't forget that even simple small things to fairly complicated levels of ease of doing business-related reforms were carried out by this government in its earlier tenure, continues even now. Whether it is self-certification, whether it is looking at environment clearances, just compare the time that an environment clearance took in earlier regimes and what is happening now. We've not lost that momentum. We are keeping that high on our agenda. And about the labor reforms, taxation reforms, irrespective of any other one or two points that each one of us might have, this could have been better this way, that could have been better that way. In spite of that, we have kept that momentum, and I'm just recalling that so that we don't forget the fact and we don't treat it as, you know, we have taken it for granted, which is good. Indian economy and the society should take for granted many things which relate to ease of doing business and ease of living too. And that's the agenda with which we are moving forward. We have not slowed down, or we have not even forgotten that. With that said, you can see in the slide that we've provided here that continuously efforts are being taken by each one of the departments. Taxation, I'd like to draw your attention before I get into specifics of other things, just so that this makes the backdrop to everything which is being talked about. Is this government going to care for us? Is this government understanding what is happening in the ground? Is this government responsive enough to the changes which are coming? We are responsive. I want to assure everybody that the momentum with which we want to carry forward reform will continue, just to draw your attention for a few things that are happening here. Pre-filling of IT returns. Revenue Secretary has been talking about it. Now the ease with which you can file your returns will be a lot more simplified if it is all pre-filled and all that you have to do is to change any corrections that you have to make. So that strain is off you. Similarly, there will be faceless scrutiny from Vijayadashmi Day this year, which will mean that there shall not be even that one odd, I don't want to use the word, but for want of better word, one odd over-enthusiastic officer who might go and, you know, sit and talk about things which may be construed as harassment. That will not happen because the whole process is going to become faceless. and it will be randomized. So it's not everybody, it's not going to be that everybody is going to be a faceless scrutiny will happen. No, it will be randomized. Big data details are being utilized. So for somebody who's got to be as scrutinized, let's say sitting in Noida, his assessment might go to Assam. So faceless scrutiny is something which is coming in from Vijayadashmi Day. Reduction of GST returns and simplified taxation and also the number of forms is really being worked upon. And I surely assure you, sooner the GST will come up with even more simplified and less number of forms. The refund process, I must underline here, has almost become automatic. Glitches where they exist, even yesterday when I was sitting with the tax administrators, I very clearly said the refund should be going through as a process, free flow. But if there are obstructions to it, we are very clearly, even tomorrow I'll be holding a meeting with, Sunday morning, 11 o'clock, I'm holding a meeting with the GSTN people to make sure and identify as to where the glitches are in terms of flow of refund so that it doesn't affect people. And if we think that the system is being gamed or if there are tweakings manually being done, I've assured that we shall take action against anyone who's gaming the system. That's as regards the refund process for the GST simplification. And then finally, repeating one other thing which I mentioned along with the faceless scrutiny, is risk-based approach is being taken in dealing with the taxpayers where there is high risk, where there is suspicion based on ground factual records. Action will be furthered rather than approaching everybody with a fishing expedition, as it were. So there are simplifications being done in the taxation. Labor laws, I'll just very quickly go through because you know fixed-term employment has been facilitated so that there will be flexibility in hiring. Contribution to the ESIC has also been reduced to 4% from 6.5%. Web-based, jurisdiction-free inspections are happening. Inspection report to be uploaded within 48 hours. So there shall not be any delay, and this is enabled already. And offences, again, a very important point from the point of view of how we are approaching ease of doing business. Compounding of offences will be the priority, no other prosecution-based actions, and self-certification, which I've already said.